The hills are alive with the sound of engines. It's race day here at the Austrian Grand Prix. It's a short lap here in Spielberg with just 10 corners, 7 to the right and 3 to the left, making up the total distance of 2.6 miles. And expect to see a lot of cars running wide today, especially through the last corner, as the wet conditions make the cars skittish through the downhill sections. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position, with Charles Leclerc alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Russell, Carlos Sainz, and Hamilton. Norris, Fernando Alonso, Ocon, and Pierre Gasly. Ricciardo, Joe, Valtteri Bottas, and Tsunoda. Mick Schumacher, Magnussen, Alex Albon and Lance Stroll. Latifi and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. Well, it's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Anthony Davidson could be a wet one today. Great to have you with us. What are your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? Well, as a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these kind of conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature and visibility. And judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
Clutch bite is good, gearbox is responding normally. Make sure to warm up the tyres and brakes. Warm the tyres and brakes throughout the lap, please. ETA on this rain clearing up is about 10 minutes, so just keep your concentration out there, you're doing well. Okay, no issues with tyre wear for now, keep taking care of them. We'll be right back. use your overtake button more. It's time to utilise some of this energy. Come on. Yellow flag. Okay, clear. No need to worry about the tyre condition for now, everything's looking good. So we're looking at another 5, maybe 10 minutes of this rain. Inters look like the best tyre for now. It looks like we're running on a dry track soon. Back to dry shortly. It's still not a perfect situation, but I don't think we've got cause to move on to a different tyre yet. Tyre condition still looking good. Lost some time to the car behind. ahead, starting to create a gap. They're just starting to pull away from us now. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 5.3 seconds. No threat of rain for the time being. Conditions look good. Okay, not sure whether Dries or Inters are faster. We're right on the crossover. Okay, we lost the position. Try to keep focus. Okay, gap ahead is 2.3 seconds. No rain expected for the time being. We're not certain which is the best tyre right now, Dries or Inters. There's a new strategy available on the MFD. Okay, copy that. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got that, confirmed. Okay, it could be a risk with the circuit this greasy, but we think the slick might now be the quicker tyre. If you think you can keep it on the road, let's consider swapping over. confirmed. Pitting this lap then, coming to the pits at the end of this lap. Lance is in for his stop. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. That was our last stop, no more scheduled pit stops, let's go. Okay, some information on Gasly. Gap to your teammate behind is 5.4 seconds. Car ahead's coming to fit the mediums. Car ahead now running medium tyres. Conditions look stable at the moment, no rain currently expected. Okay, dry seem like the best tyre for now. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. Nice work, mate. That brings you up a place. That moves us up into P14. Gap to the car in front is 3.2 seconds. It's Ricardo ahead of you. Okay, gaps in the car ahead is 4.0 seconds. They're on old mediums. Okay, their tyres are 7 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. Time last lap was a 1:09.4. You're losing around 7 tenths a lap at this pace. gap to the car in front is 2.6 seconds. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 6.8 seconds. Gasly's stopping now. Lance is in the pits. Lando's ahead of you now. Okay, gap ahead is 5.6 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are just one lap old. Your last lap time was a 1 minute 24.5. Okay, you're in the top 10. And gap to the car in front is 6.9 seconds. gap to your teammate behind is 24.9 seconds. Fastest lap at this point in time is a 1:07.5. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Okay, gap to the car ahead is 10.9 seconds. okay, you're losing a small amount of time to the car behind, so let's keep pushing. Right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps. The gap to the car in front is 13.3 seconds. Let's use overtake and burn off some of this energy. Currently, the fastest lap is a 1 minute 07.5. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 24.5 seconds. They're on old mediums. They're in 19th place. And the time last lap was a 1:10.4. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. Okay, gap ahead is 15.7 seconds. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. At the moment, the car behind is lapping faster than us by around a second a lap. Lando's ahead of you now, and gap to the car in front is 15.7 seconds. They're on old mediums. Okay, they've done 10 laps on those tyres. Time last lap was a 1 minute 08.9. We're slower by 9 tenths a lap at the moment. And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Smiling faces on the pit wall then after that superb win here in Spielberg. And rightly so. A brilliant effort from the whole team. And talk to me. What do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they secured here. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Sebastian Vettel would definitely be my first choice. He showed up a lot of the drivers out on the track today and didn't show any signs of slowing down.
Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.